It's me, Martin, and today we check out one of LG's latest televisions, the LG QNED Mini LED TV in the 65-inch version. Let's get the unboxing done, the installation and setup process, and then I will share with you my first impressions. A quick and full disclosure before we start. Not long ago, LG reached out to me and asked if I wanted to test and try out their latest model, which I said yes to. So now let's get the unboxing done. The television is shipped in this huge and heavy box, and inside we find a few things first. We have things such as documentation, the remote, batteries, cable management equipment, along with a crescent stand. The television itself is very well protected by enough styrofoam. The installation and setup is done easily. After unboxing the television, it is time to mount the stand to the crescent via 4 screws and attach it to the back of the television by 4 smaller bolts. There is a VESA mount in case you prefer to install it on the wall. In my eyes, the television looks really modern and slim, and I was definitely surprised by the thickness of the whole television. There are nicely brass metallic trims around the display, and there's a small inscription at the bottom corner of the screen. Ports are on the left rear of the display, including 4 HDMI 2.1 ports that all support 4K video because of its 48 gigabits per second bandwidth, even with DLC support. Just like the 2021 OLED models, there is the webOS 6.0 platform. It is smooth, works fast, and so far I had only one small hiccup. The dashboard loaded partially at the bottom of the display, as you can see here. The Magic Remote has a comfortable design that's easy to hold, and its point and scroll system is pretty smooth and fast too. The name QNED or QNED sounds a lot like OLED, but this television has an IPS type LED panel, which delivers wider viewing angles than a regular LCD panel. And also, contrast levels are normal for an IPS panel, which scores just under 1000 to 1. The color accuracy is incredibly good. There's an average delta error of around 1.9, which indicates that the human eye cannot perceive. Upscaling to 4K sources is mostly great too, especially when it comes to how natural the upscaled images look. LG's processor, the Alpha A7, does an outstanding job of adding in the necessary tens of millions of extra pixels without causing really any obvious unwanted processing side effects. The Mini LED TV from LG supports 3 out of the 4 HDR formats. You have HDR10, you have HLG, and you have Dolby Vision. As ever with LG, though, there is no support for the HDR10 Plus format, which, like Dolby Vision, adds extra scene-by-scene data to the HDR stream that compatible TVs can take advantage of. Compared to other LCD televisions, LG managed to create more local dimming zones, meaning that the black levels can be managed better and thus create better contrast levels and therefore deeper blacks. The local dimming is set to low by default, which causes blooming, but this can easily be solved by setting it to high. Here the setting is low, and when I turn the setting to high, it actually disappears. The higher the setting, the better it is, because it results in a brighter image and deeper blacks, which is kind of strange to me that it's not on by default. The impressive picture quality is joined by LG's typical assured audio performance. Starting in the Dolby Atmos mode, the speakers deliver an impressively large soundstage that spreads comfortably beyond the side and top edges of the screen. Dialogue sounds rich and powerful, and the soundstage avoids the sense of only appearing to exist behind the screen that you often hear with televisions that use rear-mounted speakers. The speakers don't sound harsh with shrill trebles, while at the other end of the audio spectrum it can produce impressive amounts of bass without the speaker starting to buzz or the drivers dropping out when the going gets really tough. For gaming, there is a feature, a special feature, and it's called in-game optimizer mode. Game optimizer automatically adjusts the picture settings, optimizing graphics and visibility to deliver a gaming experience no matter what type of game you're playing. LG does have a partnership with Xbox for better picture qualities and improved response times, which I will check out in the full review, so don't forget to subscribe. I've had the LG QNED Mini LED TV for a couple of days so far, and based on my first impressions, it's one of the best LCD panels and televisions that I've seen for a while and tested myself too, and therefore I believe it's one of the best that you can probably get at the moment. I'm making a second video with my full review, more technical analysis, so if you want to stay up to date with my impressions and full review of this television, click on the red button below this video. I do like the design a lot, and the picture quality is great, which is mainly due to the large amount of local dimming zones. This allows a higher contrast level and deeper blacks compared to other LCD TVs. One of the points that I didn't like is the amount of reflection that's going on. It is also tricky to compare and compete it to an OLED television and its picture quality, mainly because it's lacking two important features: full aerial dimming and a powerful backlight. But so far, guys, I've shared with you my first impressions, the unboxing, and the setup and installation process. Alright, that's it for this video. In case you have any questions, drop them down below because I would love to help you out in the meantime while I'm producing the full review. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions, drop them down below. And as always, I hope to see all of you in the next one.